Hello YouTube, it's Friday, February 24th. I'll show a little bit more about what's going on in the stereos right now. We got this one set up for stereo A on February 17th, and I just thought I'd show you a few things as I just looked at this this video here, and all I got to say is if this isn't the moon, and where is the moon? Because this is exactly where the moon is supposed to be, and it's performing exactly as the moon should perform, as seen by the SDO satellite. So if that isn't the moon, someone please tell me where the moon is. So we go on and look ahead, and looking at this little spot here, I can tell you what that is right there. That's Venus coming onto the screen. Happens every time Venus comes on or off the screen, and you can take and look that up. I got one of the best movies that I found about it is over here. It's still Venus. This is the stereo woes. It was created a while back in 2010. But it goes through and talks about all the little anomalies that you see and whatnot. And it's a very good place to look. I recommend it. And also, you can find the older movies from over here at this place. This is the Naval Labs place. This particular date right here is about the same date. We can you get a double dose. You get Venus going off the screen on one and Venus coming on the screen on the other, so you get a double explosion. And the big old meatball that was named by Beano's the one that named it meatball here. What it is, it's a reflection, and whenever Venus comes on the screen, it comes on the screen and it passes Venus and goes off in the other direction. It happens every time. You can look back through all these records and see that. And you see it right there leaving the screen as Venus is leaving the screen. You see the big explosion Venus puts off there when it's leaving the screen. And over on the other side over there, you get to see Venus approaching. There it is right there. That's the same one that Donny showed you. And it happens every time it comes on and off. In fact, it's fixing to happen again. And you can find all these videos over on the website. Got them all right in here. You just choose the date that you want there and the instrument you want, and it has the list of movies there, and it's real nice and easy to find. But if you don't want to look that up and download those, I made a video of all of them. I made it two parts, first 2007 and then 2008 to 2011. On the first one, I had the biggest lens flare ever. This is the Earth right here, not Venus, but the Earth. It just happened to be very close to the satellite and very bright at that time. And it puts on the biggest reflection and explosion I've ever seen. And that's not Venus, that's the Earth right there. So that's also on there. It was back, well, what is there? That's 2007, 328. It does that. That was caused by the Earth right there. That's on the beginning of this movie. It's also on the movie before that. And if you wanted to look it up another way, you go over here and look at it and just click on that right there, and it'll open up a new window. And the new window will look like that. And you just take and click on the stars, planets, and comets there. It'll take you over there, and hey, look at this. Not only do you get to see the Venus explosion here, but you also get to see the Milky Way. And the Milky Way comes on the screen every year. Same thing, gives you the same little showing there. Nothing new about it. And you just click on that, and it'll give you a nice picture of it. And no, that's not a rogue planet right there. In fact, if you go and look at the other window over here, you'll see that's Mercury, and there's the Milky Way. And this is back on 2009. If you run it through, you see Mercury cruising across the background of the Milky Way, as seen by Stereo B. So nothing strange going on there either. It's Mercury crossing the Milky Way. But I guess it's strange for some people. I made a movie about the other stuff over here. This was the famous Cylon battle cruiser. Someone wanted to argue with me about calling it battle this and battle that. Hey, it's Battlestar Galactica, man. I didn't make the name up, but it was another nice reflection here going on. And that was back in January 2nd. I came out with that one. And we'll go on to look at what we're seeing right now. We'll go back to the other window, stereo A. And what you're seeing right now is nothing special. It comes across every year. I don't know why people are wondering what it is. It's been around for hundreds of years. It's you got two stars right here and two what they call NGCs. Now, what's an NGC? Well, if you don't know what an NGC is, you can go over here and look it up. It's basically, it stands for New General Catalog, and first one's written up way back in the 1700s or 1600s. The new one was compiled in 1880 or so. The first one, I think, was a lot longer back than that. Basically, you have a whole lot of things called NGCs, and that's what NGC stands for. And so when we start to talk about these objects here that Donnie wants to talk about, he says he's going to investigate them. I hope he does. That's the NGC 2168 there. And also it's Messenger 35. And over here we got NGC 2174. And well, let's see what it has on the online info for that one here. Okay, NGC New General Catalog 2174. Oh, Monkey Head Nebula. Ooh, sounds like a nice name for someone. But we can go on ahead and look from there. And they give you a link over here from 2008. That's okay, so that's what it looks like there. Let's see what it looks like on the screen here. It's a different color scheme there. So we'll take and center on it there and run it in and see what it looks like. And oh, look at that. Looks a little bit like it, but it's a little bit off in the alignment. These people don't know how to align their cameras correctly, is all I can say. That little notch right there is the giveaway, though, and here's your two major bright spots there. So we can go back over here, and there's a little notch right there. And they should have it oriented to the equatorial, but that doesn't work. Not much better in the ecliptic. So we'll take and line it up with the galactic. Oh, there we go. That looks much better. Okay, so now we got it lined up a little bit closer to what's in the picture. And one too far. And we'll take and look at what it looks like compared to what's in the picture. And if you look at what's in the picture, you'll see your two main stars here, and that would be two main stars right here and there. In fact, that's a cluster of stuff right there. But then you got that little triangle right there, and you got the little L shape down there. And if you look at the picture over there, you can see the little triangle right there. It's the same triangle I just pointed out. And down here is the little L. And from there, you got the two stars over there on the edge. And that's those two stars right there. So it's a match. I also got these three right here. And you go back and look at the picture. You got the same thing on the picture. You got these three right here. And you can go on and identify everything in there. So just wanted to let you know, Donnie, that's what's called a NGC. And it was made by, this picture was made by a person over here, not affiliated with NASA. This is a backyard guy, and he shows his equipment right there, and that's his little house with his telescopes in it right there. And you can go down through here and look for it, and there it is right there. And this particular picture, guy spent days making that picture. In fact, he stacked something like 8 hours worth of photography on there. Seven, two. A lot of time was spent making that image, and that's the image that you see on the astronomy picture of the day. So anyway, that's what it is. It's a nebula, emission nebula, I believe they call that. But I just looked it up for you, so you don't have to look it up. You don't have to do any research. It's really quite easy to research if you know how to research. And this one here, we can take a look at it also. And that's what it looks like. It's not a star. That's why it doesn't look like a star. It's a nebula, an open cluster, NGC. And you can look that up also, but they kind of make it difficult for you. Oh, here we go. Messenger 35. Okay, so that wasn't too difficult. Here's a picture of it over here. And they talk about it up here. No, it was discovered back in 1745. That was a long time ago. And what was the other one he was talking about? Something up at the top. Oh, this one up here. Oh, look at there. Another open cluster. That's the one. That's M37. I think they're not too up on M37, so we'll have to take and look up that M37. And there it is right there. Okay, so there's that one too. It's no, look, another NGC 2099. Okay, so identify that one for you too. Oh, research stuff is fun. Okay, so what else should we talk about here? I think we already identified. Oh yeah, he likes to talk about Aries. Oh, Antares. There, Antares. That's what he's looking at there, and it's right on the edge of the Milky Way. And it comes across every year. And see if we can get that. I think it was there. Oh, there's the meatball again. This one across the next one. And he's still showing the same stuff. Okay, there you go. That's Aries there. Or Antares. So let's. And there it is. No, that's not it. That's Aldebaran. That's the other one he wants to talk about. We'll research that too. And should be right on the edge of the. Oh, there's the Milky Way. And there it is, Antares. And you can always tell when you're looking at Antares because it's got some nice stars around it that's pretty easy to identify. You can see these three up here, that one over there, you got these three, and look at there's another NGC. There are a lot of NGCs out there, and I know they don't look like stars because they're a whole bunch of stars and they're a long way away. So what's the deal with the next one here? Well, that's pretty easy to identify there. You got those three stars right there. You got those three items right there. That's not a star, that's an NGC. Remember that now. And you go up there, you can see that pattern up there that I was talking about. It makes it kind of easy to identify. Come off of those three there, and you go out to that one there. That's this one here. And then you go up to this three right here. That's those three right there. And then you got the one above it there. That's this one here. So that makes it across the screen every year, just like the rest of them, and it doesn't change, it stays the same. And no, the Pleiades. I'm ever going to hear the end of the Pleiades. I guess not, but we'll go back and look at the Pleiades one more time. That's back over here. And where is the Pleiades? There it is. That's the Pleiades, and the little thing that was flashing, well, that's Aldebaran of Star Wars fame. Remember Aldebaran? Nasty things happened to Aldebaran in Star Wars. So that's Pleiades, and the thing that he's talking about flashing down there is Aldebaran, and it's been that way forever. And back going through the Milky Way. And if that ain't the moon, where is the moon? And now he's talking about the NGC. So yeah, it kind of looks three-dimensional, yeah, because it's an NGC. It's not a star. It's a cluster of stars. You can find that real easy, you know, if you just look it up. It's Wikipedia. NGC. All right. So what else were we talking about? I think that's about it. still talking about that faked picture. Can you believe the man is still talking about the Photoshop picture that he tried to pawn off to people on the internet? And people are still listening to him after doing that. It's amazing. And oh, by the way, that's not Comet Holmes. That's Comet Hartley. Please call it by its correct name. Since you stole the image, you ought to know what it is. Anyway, so that's a nice fake one there. I guess that's all I'm going to talk about, except for, I grew up in South Georgia. My parents did anyway. And we have a lot of stuff around there looking like that after rain. It's red clay. And red clay makes lakes red. That kind of looks like pollution there, but I didn't even research it a bit. It just looks like kind of pollution to me. And I've seen an awful lot of stuff look like that in Georgia. I've swam in a lot of stuff that looked like that, as a matter of fact. Double signs, please give me a break. All right, so I guess that's about it. And if you want to know any more about NGCs or Pleiades or messenger objects, just let me know. And these are stars here. That one there and that one there. We can zoom in on it a little bit there. And that is a star, and that is a star there. But that's a NGC, and that's a NGC. And he did get it right, though. This is in Orion. But this one up here is in Gemini. So I guess we'll leave it at that. And is where are we looking there? Well, that looks kind of bright through there. What do you think that could be? You think there might be something going on there? Oh, I think we're going through the Milky Way again. Or at least having the Milky Way in the background. So I guess we'll leave it for next time and talk to you later.